Well, the decline in the use of cash has forced the banks to offer a financial lifeline to cash transit company Armaguard.
For more, let's bring in John Keogh, economics editor of the Australian Financial Review. Ooh. Johnny, good morning.
Hey, boss.
Hello there, mate. Now, Armaguard being at risk of collapse is a bit of a problem.
Yeah, this is a big issue, guys. So you'll recall a couple of months ago we spoke about how the use of cash for payments has declined from 63% in 2010 to just 13% around now. And that's because we're all using our iPhones more, smartphones, card payments, obviously. But that makes the economics of the cash transit industry, led by Armaguard, those big trucks we see outside the shopping centre, unprofitable. And so the banks and the retailers are trying to get together and provide a financial lifeline to this company that's actually ironically owned by the billionaire Lindsay Fox.
What's the risk?
Well, there's a couple of big risks here. Obviously, it'd be a huge inconvenience if this fell over and they couldn't get cash to retailers and banks and that sort of thing. So they're trying to put some kind of safety net together. But the other risk that the banks are really worried about is that actually, if people start to notice that cash is not as readily available in supermarkets and places like that, they might start to question the safety of their deposits at the bank and wonder if they're at risk. Now, they wouldn't actually be at risk, but it might cause a little bit of distrust in the banking system. And that's why the banks want to nip this in the bud and make sure there's still cash circulating in the economy.
Yeah, all right. Now, the Australian Financial Review Banking Summit kicks off today. You've got the NAB CEO, outgoing CEO on the hot seat.
And he drives a ute.
This is the funny thing. So yeah. Ross McEwan, it's his last week in the job, NAB CEO. He's going to be at the summit today talking. And so my colleague's written this story today on the front page saying, actually, he had his car nicked, a big fancy car, twice when he was the Royal Bank of Scotland CEO in London. So he thought, bugger this, yeah. I'm just going to drive an old ute around and no one wants to steal that.
And there's good news for utes as well.
Oh, it's good news for utes, yeah, because good segue there,
yeah,
Carl. Yeah, the emission standards by the Albanese government look like they're going to be watered down a little bit. I think Albo has pulled the chain there. He's seen the politics and Chris Bowen's given a little bit of ground.
Yeah, there's no doubt. Thank you, buddy.